Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Today we'll show you how to remove and replace a radiator on Mercedes CLK W208. Stay with us guys, let's go ahead and start on it. Also, if you need links for tools and parts used, we'll have them on our website mechaniclifestyle.com. Check it out guys. So first we need to go ahead and drain the coolant. It's not very complicated, but make sure you have a good tub to collect it. Because that's poisonous stuff, don't spill it everywhere. And we'll have a video how to bleed the cooling system after that as well, because if you don't do it right, you might overheat the car. So we have the front end in the air on jack stands, so that way we can get to the bottom of the car and the radiator. Now we'll need to remove that cover here, okay, with 8mm socket. Okay, it's missing some bolts. This one is broken here, so the two on the front were not even holding. Okay, we'll go ahead and remove this one now. And you can see everything is underneath here. So if you guys go under the vehicle right here, towards the driver's side, left side, okay, that's where the drain plug is located. So get a big screwdriver and get this one loose. It will start leaking coolant. Okay, you can see like that. So just open it all the way that you can. And you need to do something else because it's not going to come out now because there is vacuum in the system. So you need to go ahead, open the cap. And you can hear it leaking now, how fast it's going. So we're going to give it about 5 to 10 minutes at least so it can drain good and we'll proceed with the next step. Alright guys, so we removed the air box to have more room. Super simple procedure. We have the video on our channel if you need to. So now, as you know, this one, they didn't install the right clips on the fan. So we'll have to remove those clips here. And you need to disconnect the wires, okay, for the fan. Okay, already done that. So once you do that guys, okay, you'll be able to pull the fan, pull up just a little bit. Okay, on both sides, then move a little bit. You have to move a little bit one way to get out. Okay, like that. And you can just pull it straight out now. Okay, like that. So we got to the radiator now, here. You can see. And we have a few things that we will need to disconnect now. Alright guys, so now we have two hoses that we will need to remove. Okay, let me show you where exactly they are. Okay, this right here. One on the bottom and this one. Those are the big water hoses. And the clamp is usually towards the bottom, facing towards the bottom. So you need to remove those with a flathead screwdriver. And we'll need to disconnect transmission lines as well. Oh, okay. Almost dropped the two. And now we're removing the second one here on top. And this one is stuck really good. Okay, it's going now. Okay. So now I'm going to go ahead and pull this one out. Okay, it's coming out now. Okay, we dripped a little bit and we dropped the clamp. And now this is the big one. A little bit more coolant left in it. Okay, good thing we had the container underneath. Okay, so we have a 3/4 wrench now to remove the transmission pipe here, the line, transmission line. So we got this one loose. We have one on the bottom as well to take this one off. And we have a 110 millimeter bolt, guys, that we need to remove. It's a clamp that holds the transmission line towards the radiator. Okay, I'm talking about, okay, you can see the transmission oil we're going to leak now, so you always have to have a container. It will not be much oil because it's only whatever it's left in the cooler. Okay, this one is out now. Then what we'll need to do is remove this one on top here. Okay, careful, he has a washer on this side. Okay, so not to lose the washer. And now we will need to remove, guys, there is two bolts holding the radiator towards the condenser here. Okay, but that right here, hard to get to. But we're just going to go ahead and remove that whole piece on top. If you want to break your fingers, go ahead and remove it. So now we need to remove those clamps right here holding the radiator. Okay, you just press in and pull out. There is one clip that we need to remove here. Okay, this one is a little bit tight. Okay, so we're going to get the trim removal tool that we have. Again, the links will be on our side, guys, if you need to get any tools. And sometimes those clips will break, unfortunately. Okay, you pull the center piece like that, and then the rest of the clip. Okay, and we can go ahead and remove it now. We have the cable here for the lock. Okay, I'll just take this one out of the way now. And now we have two bolts here that we'll need to remove for last, okay? Because before that, we will need to remove the hose that goes on top. Okay, excellent. Let's go ahead, take these ones off, 10 millimeter. And this one is spinning inside here, so that's a problem. It's rusted really bad. Perfect, it came out. You can see how much rust was in there. Okay, this one is a done deal now. So what we're going to do, guys, we'll just grab it on this side. We'll pull it up. And this is your radiator right here. You can see how nasty on the front side it is. Okay, let's put it this way, so we don't get oil everywhere, and check it out. It definitely needs cleaned. So if you need to remove the condenser, AC condenser, guys, you won't need to remove the radiator all the way. You don't need to unhook everything. Okay, but now I have the room to show you what you need to do. These two lines, you need to disconnect those two lines. Make sure that you don't have any Freon in the system, otherwise it's going to spray in you, and that's not good stuff. It's not healthy, it can hurt you really bad. So if you vacuum down your system, disconnect these two lines, disconnect the two bolts, you'll be able to pull that thing out of there as well. So this is, guys, the whole procedure. Thank you, guys, for watching. Please subscribe and see you next time.